This is Dolly with Real Talk TV, and our guest today is B. Rob, and he's from Austin, Texas. This is an awesome artist, and I hope y'all just enjoyed that song that is Down by the Y, but I call it Ooh Wee. I've been enjoying that song since I heard it.
Yo.
Oh, now, let me, this, P. James.
Y'all already know, man. P. James, I'm in the building right now. You know, we got your boy B. Rob.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? We're going to be getting in touch. You know what
already,
I'm
no doubt.
I mean, with that being said, man, B. Rob, tell everybody exactly who you are, where you from, and what you got going on for yourself.
Oh, man, my name is B. Rob. I'm originally from Elgin, Texas, resided to Austin, Texas at the age of 9, you know what I'm saying? And, man, I just, you know, I really got a lot going on as far as, you know, R&B, blues, zydeco, just music in general, hip hop. You know, I come from that era where, You know, I produce all of my material, also produce for other people as well. But man, I just love music. So, you know, I'm not stuck in one category. I love all types of music. So, you know, whatever comes to mind and that's what I'm feeling, that's how I go in the studio and rock with it. You know what I'm saying?
So I know, I love that ooh-wee. So,
exactly. Like, when did you get started, you know, doing music and entertainment exactly?
Really and truly, I come up in the church. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's what my talent, you know, really evolved in church. And, you know what I'm saying? To me, how I see it, I've always been in church doing music, playing for my church, this and that. But, you know, as coming up as a child, like I say, you know what I'm saying, my mom and dad and them was, you know, they listened to all type of music, blues. Until Zydeco came through, it was just blues, R&B, you know, and all type of other music.
Right.
And so, you know what I'm saying, it just evolved in me, man. And, you know, as I grew, you know, I started learning new instruments and, you know what I'm saying, playing them in the church. And, you know, by me loving music, you know, I ventured out and started, you know, doing my own thing, writing music, you know, producing it and working with other people.
Now, you also, when you perform, y'all have a band. Y'all actually have a live band.
Yes, ma'am.
Which is rare. Not everybody has that anymore.
I hear you.
That's awesome.
They got a band right there, microphone and the DJ.
Going off the track, guys. That's what's up, though.
No, don't do no nilly. on the series, but y'all actually do have a live band.
Yes, ma'am.
With
you. I sure do.
I wish they would have been able to come tonight. You know, today. Oh. We was hoping for that, but
short notice.
Yeah, I had called my band, and it was like, well, B Rob, man, we wish we had it known earlier. And I'm like, yeah, I know, but it, you know, yet still, we will be back though, Mr.
We're gonna get you back. We have to do it on a Saturday.
Right. Sounds good to me.
Get it on a Saturday and do that. Get you on a Saturday afternoon out here and get to do it done.
Cool.
Get the band and that'll work. I can't wait to hear that.
Yeah,
that's gonna be really good.
Man, that's where I come from.
So, how did you come up with "Ooh Wee" in this? With the down by the Y.
You know what? I thought about it because, you know, just to be honest, you know what I'm saying? I'm a very sexual man, so.
Oh.
You know, just put it out there. But you know, B Rob love the women, so
just keep it real.
But I came up with it. I thought about it, and you know. I was thinking about it, I was in that mode to where, you know, I was kind of in the studio grooving, and I'm like, ooh-wee, you know what I'm saying? And just came up from there, and then I'm like, oh, man, you know, I'm finna put the beat together. So I put the beat together, and then after I made the beat, that's when I wrote it. You know, stuff just went to rolling, and really, actually, I really freestyled that whole song. I was feeling stuff, and nothing on paper.
And you see, that's where I tell so many artists where you gotta find a song that people are gonna feel.
Right.
That's right.
Get a song people are gonna move to.
No doubt.
And that's a song women gonna get up and dance to. we want to ooh wee on there.
That's what I'm talking about.
I'm gonna rename it to ooh wee. That's all I think
I'm gonna start
about.
Calling it ooh wee.
I love the ooh wee.
But you know what? When I met you, when I said the name of it was.
Yeah, that's what
you
sure
said.
Was
ooh wee.
Exactly.
And it's down by the Y. But I, you know, think. And I say that for every song.
Uh-huh.
There's got to be a catch in that song
that's
that everybody's going to pick up.
That's right. Right. That's right.
You know, and in that song, ooh-wee is it.
Yeah,
you know, ooh-wee, ooh-wee, yeah.
And, you know, that's just like, you know, in all of my material, I always try to come up with a hook that I know that's, if the hook is not moving me, then I feel like it's not going to move the people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So if that hook grabbed me and, you know, I'm singing it, you know, the next day it's in my head, I'm like, yeah.
That's it.
I think it's gonna rock. You know what I'm saying?
And it sure do.
Yeah.
It sure do.
Thank you.
I always say, bro, the more you go, the more you grow.
Yeah, that's real talk.
I keep saying I want a hashtag.
You stop watering plants, what's gonna happen?
Yep, that's right. The plants gonna die.
That's right.
Now I have a question. Who inspired you?
Really and truly, my mother, Lord rest her soul, my mother was an evangelist minister and a gospel singer.
Oh.
You know, and she's the one that really inspired me. Now I had, you know, some other people, other artists, from gospel to rap to R&B to Zydeco to blues. It's just a variety of people that really, you know, that
inspired
me.
Well, you can tell in your music,
But my mother was, you know, she was my number one, well, God first, but my mother, you know, besides God, my mother was my inspiration.
So other than yourself,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying, who who is your biggest, like, what is your biggest motivation, and what motivates you to continue to do what you do?
One of my motivations is you know, I told my mother that I would never stop, because I kind of took a backseat for a minute, and when my mom, you know, taken sick, so I took a backseat for a minute, and she was like, you know, before she got ready to you know, pass away, she was like, son, don't you stop, because you got it. And I was like, you know, and you know, when my mom passed away, I had to, you know, kind of chill for a minute and take a back seat, and then, you know, fire started burning, and you know, I thought about everything that she said. So that is part of my motivation.
Right.
It's for myself, but not only for me, for my mother, because she believed in me, and I had to believe in myself and knew that I had it all along as well. I knew I had it, but you know, like I say, when I took a hit, you know, when my mom passed away.
That'll bring you.
Yeah, it did. But you know, overall though, you know, mm-hmm. I'm back, and I thank God for that. You know what I'm saying? And my mother is my number one inspiration.
That's right.
Yes,
you
sir.
Know what I'm saying, hey, man, that's I'm with that.
That's touching.
Evangelist Bernie L. Robinson.
Yeah, I lost my mom
that's
this
my
year, and it's like, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That is a blow.
Yeah.
That's what's up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, man, look, tell everybody them YouTube links. Give them the links. Feed them that. You know what I'm saying? So they can go check out the song for themselves. Check out the video.
I tell you what, if you go to YouTube and go to, just put in B-Rob, I'm Just Doing Me. That's my Blues and Zydeco album. Or you can put in B-Rob Resurrected.
And that's
my R&B album. And it'll take you straight to the links. Yeah.
Let's talk about that album, man. Mm-hmm. How many songs you actually got on that particular?
It's 10 songs on that one, on my R&B album.
R&B.
Uh-huh. B-Rob Resurrected. Yes, sir.
Make sure y'all go contact, man.
I need to send
yes,
this to some DJs. DJ Flex, you're getting one. I'm sending this to
that's
you, right?
What's up.
Yeah, ASAP.
P. James already bumped that on the radio. So,
P. James got his to be bumping on the radio.
That's what's up.
So Mr. CEO, I need your address. I'm sending you that.
Yeah. But you know what, though? We're gonna capture the audience, because around here, like, the particular style of
uh-huh.
music that you have, you
mm-hmm.
know what I'm saying? It feeds into Louisiana's culture, man. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
like, us as, you know, as people,
mm-hmm.
when we like music, when we listen to music,
right.
we like certain types of music.
Right.
You know what I'm
right.
saying? When we go out of state, out of town, they don't play that type of music.
I got
you. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So,
because
yeah,
I was surprised that he wasn't from
yeah.
out here.
Right. What you bring it to the table is going to definitely cater to the audience
right.
within this particular brand.
Right.
In this particular city and state.
Right, right.
And yeah, now we got Texas in the house.
What part of Texas you from?
From Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
Austin, Texas
Austin,
in the
Texas.
House.
Yes, sir.
Did you get to go see the game?
Which one?
The Astros.
No, I didn't.
Oh,
no,
I watched
I
that. Oh, all right. Okay, tell us about the next song that's coming on.
The next song is Selfie off of my R&B album called B-Rob Resurrected. And matter of fact, got a remix that I will be dropping sometime in probably February featuring Bria Lachey.
Oh,
yeah.
R&B, upcoming and upcoming R&B artist
oh,
that,
okay.
that I'm working with right now.
Wow.
That's
no, because he's gone. So it's on YouTube, right?
Yes.
They can catch the video and everything on YouTube?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, all your songs have videos? Just
not all of them.
Good bit of them.
I think I have, I think it's five. I have five videos.
I was
going
to say five or six,
uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah,
I know, but I know Uwe's on there.
So what's the name of the song we're about to get into right now?
Now, this one is I have a video to this, and it's called Selfie.
Selfie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Taking selfies.
That's me.
You?
I'm always
got
that phone.
Let's go, man. We're going
to run that
selfie.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, I'll be playing with the phone, and I'm always taking selfies. I'm like Kim Kardashian.
And you know what's so crazy? I seen
yeah.
a dude the other day with a hat
yeah.
that said selfie.
Yeah,
I need that hat.
I'm telling you.
I need that shirt. I need a shirt to say that. It's selfie.
Yeah.
Anybody really trying to buy me a Christmas present? Buy me a shirt that say selfie. Because I'll be taking all kinds of selfies of myself. I take selfies of everybody. I'll be taking pictures.
That's what's
our little
up
camera
right
lady ain't with us today. She had to work. We miss Kitty, we missing you.
Yeah.
I have a friend of mine that comes and takes pictures for us.
Uh-huh.
She uses my phone and she's be clicking the pictures.
and
we be missing
yeah.
us. Yeah.
Yeah, camera lady.
That's
what
what's
my
up.
Camera lady. Yeah. That's what we call our camera lady.
That's what's
she's
up
such
right
a sweetheart
there.
Too. She really is.
Yeah. And we gotta continue to move. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Everybody in the city.
Three minutes.
Is willing to go ahead on and be serious about your business. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know how to contact me. You know what I'm saying? Through Dolly Pierre. Y'all can hit me up on Facebook, or Instagram, or whatever the case is. But
y'all can contact him, but he gonna tell y'all contact Dolly.
Call Dolly. So you know, it's so much. They come in and out. You know what I'm saying? That we don't want to have people that come in and out.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We'll let y'all out of y'all to come on the show and get y'all promo and everything like that. But it takes a team. You know what I'm saying? To actually move. You know, a business, especially something like this. So if y'all don't think that this is serious, you know what I'm saying, or y'all think it's a joke or whatever, then y'all can just continue to do what y'all got to do. We're going to continue to do what we got to do.
It ain't going to stop me. Because the joke will be on you, baby. That's how I put it. The joke will be on you. You know, I say I won't make Oprah's bread, but I want to be like Cookie.
That's what's up, right?
But then, yeah, they call me the Barbara Walters of the music industry.
Oh,
that's
okay.
What somebody called me. I said, what? I said, okay, I don't have to take that good. I said, y'all call me an old woman. Baby, I'm only as old as I feel.
I know that's right.
Now, some days I feel old. But I don't act old.
I hear you on that. don't nothing really get old but clothes, and
that's
even that
right.
Come back in style. You know what I'm saying?
even that come back in style.
I guarantee you somebody will bust out with some Jabos, guess what?
And next week, everybody wearing Jabos. what the hell?
Yeah.
How that happened?
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt.
I was thinking about giving me something too, so look. I'm just throwing it out. Don't do it.
Don't do it. Put that back in the closet, baby. I know. I came across a pair of Jabot shorts the other day.
Oh, Jabot's clean,
yo. Yeah, they said, man, you know, I'm really liking these things. But I said, if I be wearing that, they say, Miss Dylan, lost her mind.
I still got a pair of Jabot.
I think we all do.
The thing I didn't want.
I'm trying to tell you, still starts and I ain't ready. You know what I'm saying?
All right, we're going to now listen to your song. Your song's on right now.
Yeah,
and man. It's called Selfies.
Yeah.
He made that for me, yeah, y'all. He just didn't know that.
That's what's up.
You know, the same thing with Ooh-wee.
Say, girl, you know I've been missing you. You so far away. But as long as I got my phone and you got yours, we gonna send these selfies.
You got me taking selfies, taking selfies, taking selfies for you on my phone, on my cam. I'm sending selfies. You got me taking selfies.
You got me
taking selfies for you.
I'm taking selfies. On Facebook,
Twitter,
Instagram, check your message, I'm sending them. Girl, you got me feeling like I'm a photographer, taking pictures on my phone, sending that's what's up. And when you're calling and asking me what I'm doing, I'm chilling, sipping, missing, feeling on your booty. But since you're so far away, you know I miss you, baby. So I'm taking pictures on my phone. From the front, the front, the front. Take a picture from the back.
You know I like that.
Girl, you know what you're doing when you send pics to me. You got me feeling myself drinking this Hennessy. You looking so good, baby. Take a selfie. listening, babe. Check your messages. Say, girl.
All righty, that was Selfie that just played. Now tell us about Selfie.
Oh man, that Selfie, when I wrote that song, I was actually seeing someone at that time from Houston. So,
you
know,
Houston.
So at that time, you know, we was going back and forth and, you know, I was taking pictures and she's like, hey babe, send me a picture. And she's like, okay, cool, you send me some pictures, you know what I'm saying?
Right,
she was
right.
In Houston and I was in Austin.
Okay.
And so that's when I came up with that song, you know, you got me taking selfies. I was feeling that at the time, in which I was. She was taking selfies, so that's basically.
You know what, though, that's good.
And you see, I like that.
A lot of songs come from, you know, experiences that happen in your life. Even some of my songs that I dealt with, like experience.
Yeah, that's
even
right.
Even though it's rap, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It came from somewhere.
Oh,
like I just pick up the pen, start saying blah, 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 blah.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Y'all don't want me to write those.
Yeah, the majority, matter of fact, you know,
my song would be whack.
You know, matter of fact, both of these albums that I just put out really came from experiences. The whole album is all of my experiences.
But you
so
know
anything
what
you hear on
you,
that,
you
I
put
did
it in,
that, I lived that.
And you know what I find that you did different?
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of artists will say that.
Uh-huh.
I write about my life's experiences.
Right.
But what I find you did different is it's how you put it.
Right.
You put it into where it's a movement. It's
right
that people go feel it.
I hear you.
You know, it's not just I was on the corner and this, whatever these this street. I mean, you really made people feel it.
Thank you.
You know, and that's the thing about it. It's like I could clean house every day of the week now with this up here.
That's what's up. I love to hear that type of feedback.
You know, you're making people feel that, and that's what they want.
And that's what I try to do. You know, with the music. The type of music that I write and produce, you know, I want people to be able to, you know, feel it and relate to it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and that's my thing. You know, I love, and when I make music, I love music. And when I'm making music, I make it for myself, but not only for myself, for the people that's been going through different situations or may have lived this type of life or that type of life, but I'm just telling my story.
Right.
Yeah.
But that's the best way to do music, man. If you can't do music like that.
Yeah.
You're not an artist. You're not an entertainer.
Right.
I mean, anybody can get on stage and do what they do.
Yeah.
But listen, some of the songs that Michael Jackson then produced, those were experiences.
Yep, that's right.
Right.
It's not, that's just experience. People that.
Yeah.
Where did that come from? Where did he get that topic from?
Yeah, that's
did
right.
he just make that up?
Yeah, that's right.
No, something inspired
every song was.
That's
good.
Right.
Has
no
a
doubt.
From somewhere.
That's what it's about.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Look at Taylor Swift. Boy, you know all her life. She put it all in a song. Beyonce's last album.
Yeah.
That's right.
Lemonade.
Yeah.
Ooh, she got some feelings in there.
Right. Yeah.
But
you know what? Look at the money she making from that.
Yeah, that's right. That's
she
right.
bringing in that paper on that.
That's right.
And that's where I try to tell people about their music.
Yeah.
Look at who's making money.
Mm-hmm.
Look who's doing something.
Yeah.
Listen to that music on that radio.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Because you know what? That money's on that radio. That music's on that radio. They bring it in some paper.
That's right.
You can listen
no
to
doubt.
The ones and tell that they don't put a lot of passion in their music.
That's true.
You know
that's true,
I mean?
Too.
Oh.
Yeah.
I could name some.
Look, Rihanna.
Yeah.
Them girls could sing.
Yeah.
Even Adele with Hello.
Yeah.
Now, who would have thought Hello?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Hello. Answer your doggone phone.
That's for real though.
If she begging you to answer that phone, I try many times. Dog don't want to forgive me. All right.
I hear
that's
that.
My interpretation of that song. But it's true. But look at the money she making on that.
That's right. That's right.
You know, look at the money they're making on that.
That's
why? Because that's songs people want to hear.
Yeah, right.
You know, songs people want to hear.
And it's like, you know, some things, like, sometimes you have some people that really want to say certain type of thing, but won't say it. But
put it
then,
in a song.
You know, me, you know, I'm type, when I'm, you know, when I'm making music, if this what comes to mind, if it's something that I'm going to say, I'm going to say it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But it's all feel-good music.
It's all
you know feel-good. That,
that's
you know,
what it's all
feel-good.
Yeah,
it's
feel
all feel-good music. But, I mean, it's just like, you know, somebody might want to say, woo, this or that. And won't say it, but well, I hear it in my song. You know what I'm saying? Because that's how I rock.
Yeah. You never know. You never know.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what. I was really impressed with your music.
Thank you.
I really do love your music. I mean, I just go on YouTube and I'll
see. So y'all been knowing each other or y'all just
connected? No, we just connected.
That's right.
And actually it was your manager?
Through Terry Brown.
Terry Brown is the one who introduced me.
Mm-hmm.
And he sent me some music to listen to.
Yeah.
And he said, I have these artists I want you to listen. No, I'll be honest, he did send me one that I didn't think, but I said, oh, but I got hooked on that one. I said, oh, no.
Yeah.
I said, I like this one. I need to put him on TV. I said, he need to come do an interview now.
Yeah. And actually, you know, that's
and
my,
it was just convenient that you were actually coming out here.
Right, exactly.
See, that's godsend.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, that's
I
a blessing.
I say the same thing.
That's what I always
say. Because you never know what places you're going to be put in or what situation you're going to be put in to be a blessing or to bless someone else.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? So I accept it how it comes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And like Terry.
I don't always say that. You never know what's going to happen.
That's right. Exactly.
You know, opportunities happen all the time.
Yeah.
God puts things in your path.
Yeah.
You just
no
gotta
doubt.
Know, you just know, got to know when to grab it.
That's right. That's right. Right. No
you know,
doubt.
Because mm-hmm. sometimes, so many times you ignore it.
Yeah, that's true.
You ignore it and then it's like, oh man, I should have done that.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, baby. Do what you got to do now.
Yeah, that's the truth.
You know, do what you got to do now.
And I got to say a shout out to Terry Brown because, you know, actually, he's from Alexandria.
Right.
And he had moved to Austin, like, I think we was living in Dove Springs at that time when I met him. And he was like, no, I'm not from here. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, at the time, he was living down there.
Yeah.
And he was like, you know, we've been friends for, like, you know, we actually had a R&B group back in the days.
Right.
You know, and so we've been friends like, I think, matter of fact, I think it was like eighth, ninth grade, something like
James
that. So.
Thing
yeah, shout out to Terry Brown, man. Appreciate you, homie.
Oh, shout out to a big shout out to Terry Brown. Thank you. I don't know exactly how you found me, but thank you. You are a blessing.
Yeah.
And God gonna bless you too.
Mm-hmm. That's what's up.
Mm-hmm.
That's real.
Well,
that is real talk.
Dolly says she want to go ahead on and start doing live shows again. You know what I'm saying? So artists that are available that she does book, you know, it's a one opportunity thing.
Right.
I mean, because live television broadcasted is more work than pre-recorded. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So with that being said, no time to waste for live because there's people who's going to be watching from all over around Louisiana, around the country. Around the states, you know what I'm saying?
You never know.
So by the time the show starts, everybody needs to be ready and prepared. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
And that's the way we run. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all interested, y'all contact Dolly Pierre. Be right. We're going to have you on the live.
Yeah,
we're going to go live on TV.
All
right. Really? And they have to understand, this man's from Austin.
Yeah.
So
they came from Austin to be here.
So
that's right.
This is
Austin.
Not Lafayette. So that means there are people out there not finding me.
Yeah.
So you never know.
So with that being said, if this man is from Austin and he drove from Austin to make it and he made it on time to do this show, how is it so hard for artists and
that local can't make it on time?
Canada Girl, Church Point, y'all can't make it to the interview. Y'all 15, 20 minutes late during a live television segment.
Right. And then, yes, we are late at times.
We
got things that happen, and we run late. But we're going to fix that. Believe
mm-hmm.
that.
And like we said, we're going to fix it. Dolly going to fix it. And everybody who didn't get a chance to come on Real Talk TV, here's another chance.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Here's another invite. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go live again. You know what I'm saying? If we don't have no shows, we're not doing long shows because we're not putting ourselves in those situations.
No.
Y'all only get, how much, what is it, 26 minutes?
We're going to start doing it 26
minutes.
26 minutes. And we're going to put it all in there, make it straightforward, get it done with.
And
you know I post the hell out of things.
And lot of people, and a shout out to my people that's incarcerated because a lot of those people be viewing our television show when we live on television
that's
because they catch those channels. They catch the AOC, they catch the local channels.
Yeah.
So the people incarcerated, the only channel they watch is the AOC because it's mostly public advertisement. So all
so it's clean. That's clean.
Yeah,
the
like basically
right.
what it meaning that it just show advertisements pretty much all day
until
somebody do a show or whatever.
Right, right.
So when we come on, they'll get to see us.
Cool,
you know, and
man. That's what's up,
because,
man.
Yeah.
You know, and I mean, everybody wrong at times, but
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, how do you say it? Do the crime, you got to do the time.
Yeah, that's real time. That's real time. No other way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we shout out to everybody.
Yeah, shout out for real. Keep your head up, man. You know what I'm saying? The ones that are that is incarcerated, man. Y'all keep your head up, man. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I took it hard with my Facebook jail.
So you know
that incarcerated was so hard on me. I did not like that.
I saw that on Facebook.
Oh,
you know,
my God. I was like dying.
About a Facebook jail. I was like, oh.
I said, don't take nothing. Don't take much to make me happy. I'm out of Facebook jail.
We go live again.
Yeah. I will not break none of y'all rules again. I do not own the rights to nothing. I will make sure y'all know that.
This is Real Talk TV. But then even with that, remember, we place artist songs that we don't own the copyright, so it's still safe to put that up there.
Yeah, it's safe to put that up there. Even if they don't have to worry about me putting those songs up there, I can't sing. If I was to come up with a song, they're going to say, oh, gosh, Miss D went crazy. She done lost her mind. Give that woman some medicine. Put that woman on some medicine, please.
That's what's
now she's trying to do. They're going to say, now she's trying to do too much.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to say, B. Rob is smart. I'm gonna come up with my own wee.
Well, I got a badge for that, man.
B. Rob, I need a sponsor. I'm going ooh wee.
My.
I'm gonna say Lord, ooh wee.
Yeah, you know that's why I got that really that my part from, you know, because you know being in church, you know what I'm saying, and then you know you hear a lot of the ministers. And
I'll be watching a lot
you know,
of the
music
on my YouTube,
stuff, man. You know, just put it together. Yeah, no doubt.
Right.
No doubt.
Music is. Mm-hmm. You can't categorize music.
Yeah, that's
especially
right.
If it don't have no profanity.
Exactly.
Oh yeah, don't have no profanity.
As much as you want about sexual content.
Yeah.
But if you're married, then it's not against policy.
Right.
So stop.
Right. There you go. That's real talk.
Stop.
Real talk.
Let me ask you a quick question on that.
Uh huh.
Where do you see yourself at in 5 years from now?
5 years.
Besides maybe a new win.
You know, I kind of see myself on a, how I put it, I guess I'd say a bigger plateau.
Mm-hmm.
As far as my music goes, as far as me being an artist, producer. I see myself, as far as becoming a household name.
Do you want to be signed by a major record label? Would you like to, or you would rather stay independent?
Yeah, I'm talking about the deals that's going on right now with the major.
I would really, really and truly, you know, since I pretty much do everything myself.
Right.
It's like, you know, if a record label does come at me, they're talking about some real good money, you know, because that's what it's about.
Right. At the end of the day.
At the end of the day, it's about the money, you know what I'm saying? I know I got good product, I produce, you know, do all my own marketing, you know, do what I do.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? If they have something more to offer, basically money, you know what I'm saying? If the money is right, then we can talk.
Right, because all they want is your money.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying?
And I do this for the love of it.
Right.
You know, it's not all about the money.
I do it for the love of it.
But now, when it comes to it, money is also a part of that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And when
so
they come to you, that's money. It's
real talk.
But money.
Real talk. They want to make money. I want to make money as well. You know, they want good product. I got good product to give.
That's right.
So you know what I'm saying?
Negotiate a reasonable deal.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Maybe possibly a distribution.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. 360.
Yeah, that's real talk. Yeah, but you know, my thing is also if they do come at me, you know what I'm saying, like that, my thing is let me be, that's going to be number one. I need to be in control of my music because this is what I'm giving the people.
Don't give
and
up
this
all
is
your
what
control.
They like. I don't need no one coming in and changing what I do.
Exactly.
You know
and
what I'm saying? So
right.
If
no,
it comes
no.
like that, I would just stay like I am an independent.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And my independent label is called Hard Hat Entertainment.
Hard
you know
hat.
What I'm saying? And that comes from hard work, you know, coming up in the construction world with my dad, you know what I'm saying, bought
right.
us up in construction. So that's where my label name came from, Hard Hat Entertainment.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what
so.
I'm saying? So underneath your label in particular,
mm-hmm.
you are the only artist or?
I have, it's me and my daughter. Yeah, it's my daughter, and that's Bria Lachey.
Oh,
yeah.
That is your daughter.
She's
22.
Yeah, she's 22.
22?
Mm-hmm.
That's what's up. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, man, that's Mm-hmm. What's her name again?
Bria Lachey.
Bria Lachey.
Y'all look her up. She's on YouTube. Now, she's in one of your songs, ain't she?
Yes. She's on Raise the Roof.
Raise the Roof. Okay, I've seen her on YouTube.
Yeah, that's right. She's Raise the Roof. Yeah,
see,
featuring
her.
That's right, Miss Dolly. You
went stalking.
Yeah, you on it. Yeah, that's what's up.
You know what? I will do the digging, and I will find the stuff if it really is the music I like.
Right,
if
I hear
it's
you.
Really something I really think it's worth it,
right.
Honey, I'm gonna look SoundCloud, I'm gonna look everywhere so I can find you.
I know that's right.
That's how I am.
Right, right.
You know, so this way, like this thing, like uh-huh. Okay, yeah, he got a video with that, but yeah. I didn't realize that was your daughter.
Yes, ma'am.
See, I didn't realize that part was your daughter.
Uh-huh. That's my
but
daughter.
I knew there was a video up with her in.
Right,
there.
Right.
And she's a pretty little girl too.
Thank you.
And it's a very pretty little girl. But it's like, okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I just fell in love with your music. I love your music.
Thank you.
You know, and I wish you.
Thank you.
I wish you the greatness in this.
Thank you. I really appreciate
that. PJ, put that phone on off. But I really, really enjoy it. You know, I really enjoy your music. I wish you nothing but the best.
Thank you.
You know,
thank
and you. Anything I can do to help you,
yeah,
I will help you.
Well, I definitely appreciate it, and it just makes me feel good to know that you know that someone else appreciates your music.
Right.
You know, and that's what I do it for. You know, I do it. You know, for the people. You know, what I'm saying I do it for friends, family. You know, fans, I do it for everyone, you know.
Man,
and I know it's different strokes for different
you
folks.
You performing at weddings, I can see you performing.
Oh, I could
you
see
know,
you.
I think I've been told that to,
I see you.
I see you everywhere. I could see you opening at the casino.
Yeah, yeah.
The opening acts at the casinos,
uh-huh.
I could see you doing that.
I hear you.
And with that style of music,
right.
They're going to leave the machines to dance a little while.
That's your question.
Uh-huh.
You do shows occasionally? Or
oh, yeah. I've been doing
shows.
Matter of fact, I just we just did a Christmas show in Austin, Texas, at with KZI,
mm-hmm.
Which it was me, Cupid. Like I say, shout out to Cupid, and
shout
what
Cupid.
Was Miss Charnette Hyder,
Summer Wolf,
and Summer Wolf also.
Yeah.
Uh huh. Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what's up. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
B, matter of fact, I called B up one day and he's like, I said, B, I'm about to do Real Talk TV. Oh, man, I'm working out. Hold on, I'm about to go in there and turn it on. You know what I'm saying? They said, all right, that's what's up.
Yeah,
you know
that's what's up.
I sent you that information for that tour.
Oh, well, yeah.
With Jonathan Mitchell.
Yeah.
Send you the information on that.
Oh, yeah.
Now, that is really good because that's
I see the dates on it. Man.
Hype Magazine's behind that.
Okay,
so
okay.
So that is something that's really, really interesting. If anybody
right.
wants to know something, what's going on about a tour that Hype Magazine's behind, they
uh-huh.
have a bunch of sponsors. I can't even remember everything about it because I just got so much stuff in my head, but
right.
just contact me. I'll give them information. But
okay.
that is something I think you should really consider because there's
yes.
a lot of good cities they're going
is,
to.
It is. And when I
there's 30 cities.
Right. And when you sent it to me, I was like, man, this is going to be nice. It's going to be a good tour.
And
with all of the cities that, you know, that it's going to hit, it's going to be, man, it's going to be nice.
Are you kidding? And I actually to hit all 30 cities.
Right.
For the price that they gave for all the 30 cities.
Right.
I didn't think that was bad at all.
I hear you.
That's with your hotel too.
Right. Right.
And you get interviews. You get this red carpet stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the whole nine yards.
I hear you. That is. That's going to be nice.
That would be really nice. Then and you could get known everywhere. So.
Right. Right.
Even
man.
In venues and even in cities that you didn't even know.
Right. Exactly.
That they never heard cities that never heard this type
right,
of music.
Right, I hear you.
Them women are gonna like that. They're gonna walk out of that. Ooh-wee. Ooh-wee.
That's what's up, right? That's what I want.
But you see, people, you know, that's why with the music industry, it takes more than just, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It takes a team because while the artist is there doing his thing, somebody's supposed to be there behind the scenes. So
yeah.
as soon as the artist get off the stage,
right.
You know what I'm saying? That other person is making sure that the DJ is kept with the
yeah,
the product.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Make sure that the DJ is going to continue to play the product.
Yeah, that's
right.
right.
And the relationship
right.
between the DJ and the manager is ready.
Yeah, that's right. That's
you
real
know?
Talk.
And what's
that's
really
real
good is that on this tour, you can bring all your CDs,
yeah.
any T-shirts, anything that you have to
right.
sell, they're allowing you to sell it.
Oh, well, that's
make
cool.
Your money
you're
that's
allowed
good.
To make your money back.
Right, right.
And that is real good, you know. And the good thing about too is you never know who's gonna wind up wanting to book you.
Yep, that's right. That's the
once
main
you
thing.
Perform and that
yeah.
owner hears you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Not your phone gonna be ringing, honey.
Yeah.
I promise you, your phone gonna be ringing. You gonna get.
I hear that.
You gonna get
booked. Calling, say, man, this is this, like that.
Yeah.
Okay, this is what we require.
You know,
that's what's up. Though.
All you do is just have your game plan. You already know what you charge to perform.
That's it.
You know already know what your cost is.
That's right.
And you know what? Hey, this is what
and
I cost.
That,
you want me? This is what it's gonna cost.
Yeah, that's right.
A lot.
Yeah.
Guess what? There go your features.
Yeah.
People gonna start to hit you up.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying, like, you continue your business and then you work with the ones who you have the relationship with.
Right.
But you continue your business.
That's right.
Because
real talk.
Boosie ain't coming do no feature for me or you for free.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm
saying?
You know
real
what? And you do have to spend money to make money.
Yeah, that's real talk.
And a lot of artists think, oh, I ain't doing this and they ain't paying me.
Yeah.
Darling, sometimes you need to learn.
That's
you got to spend money to make
money.
That's right.
It's not all about money because let me tell you
but the return on this.
Right.
That's right.
The return. I'm going to have to show you this tour thing. I didn't show it to you. I forgot to send it to you. The cities they got in there.
Right.
It is awesome.
See, a lot of these major rappers, they don't always charge each other to go ahead on and do a song because you know why?
Yeah.
They know if they do the song together, they both got the ASCAP and their BMI and their business and their paperwork together.
That's right.
By them doing that and putting that out, their shares is going to be splitted
automatically. Right. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So it's no confusion why would we charge each other for a song we know me and you together on the song going to sell over 1 million copies.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm.
I can charge you 10 bands, but then that's going to come out of your expenses.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No. The music in the major market don't work like that.
Yeah, that's
they
real
only
talk.
Work like that to independent artists.
Right.
People that's not signed to their particular brand or dealing with their particular company or whatever they got going on.
Right.
I'm
going
to leave that at that.
Mm-hmm.
You know
I hear you on that.
This tour has you going to Dallas. I mean, I'm just going to give you the whole list, but you're going to Dallas, San Antonio, Arkansas, Memphis, Kentucky, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, Maryland, West Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, Alabama, Louisiana, back to Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, South California, North California, Oregon, Washington, Idaho, Nevada, Utah, Colorado, and Kansas City.
So they start, when are they starting at?
This tour starts January 16th. It's called, I can't even see this now. Oh, Lit for Days. Lit for Days tour.
Mm-hmm.
It is. It's 30 U.S. states.
That's going, that's, man,
it's
I'm
30
talking about
U.S. states.
Hitting,
30
hitting,
U.S. states.
Ooh, they hitting them all. They hitting them all.
Oh, I guess they hitting
they
it all.
Hitting
and
all.
The exposure.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I mean.
And that's what it's about,
you're touching
too,
the four
you know?
Corners.
Yeah.
You're touching the four corners where you need to be.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know.
Yeah, let me tell y'all, that's the thing. Business, right?
Yeah.
Business.
Yeah.
People don't realize how all these artists get these shows booked.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's a chain reaction.
Right.
You have a promoter that's looking into stuff like this.
That's right.
Like her.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And how do y'all get that? Well, the promoter's doing her job.
Yeah, that's
right. How y'all got it. Don't worry about that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And that's how
that's real
when you got a team
that's
working the way they need to work.
And this
mm-hmm.
is a promoter that's working for Hype Magazine that contacted me about this.
Now, see, that's what's up. That's what's up. That's the reason why, you know, I try to tell anyone, man, if you really want to make, you know, if you want to make some moves, you got to get out there and rub elbows and talk to people because you never know who knows who in order to catapult you over to here or to there.
Or
you
to
never
right.
know.
And
never
like
know
they,
who you're going to meet.
They even
you know?
Asked me if I needed a PR. They want to be my PR.
See what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about.
They know we got the Louisiana platform covered and sold up.
Right,
you know what
right.
I'm
yeah,
so
yeah.
We can expect them to come towards this direction and want to work with this platform. And we'll work with y'all platform. Louisiana to, you know what I'm saying,
to
New
all
Jersey,
over.
To Atlanta, to BET, MTV, VH1. Yeah, we'll work with y'all.
Mm-hmm.
We'll keep our platform going the way we're doing it.
Yeah.
We'll work with any platform who want to work with us.
I know that's
you know
right.
What
that's what's up.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
They'll find you. If you're doing the hard work, they will find you.
Yep, that's the truth.
And they find me for sure. they'd be fine. They,
I know that's right.
Let me tell you, they'd be finding me at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning too. They ringing my phone, but of course, time changes.
Yeah.
You know, time difference and stuff. It's like,
you know, it's crazy.
And I answer it.
Yeah.
She been doing Louisiana promo, you know, so long.
Uh-huh.
Since now, it says so long like that. But she's been doing it so long since. Look, I was a rapper, right? With my CDs out there, pressed up, printed up, and everything.
Yeah.
Going to different little clubs.
Yeah.
Passing out my CDs, trying to get my CDs exposed.
Uh huh.
She was at the door, holding the door. I didn't know her. You know what I'm saying?
You know,
so I'm like, as you do that, you know, you could do it as an independent artist, yeah. One deep. But yeah. If you don't have a team or foundation, it's kind of hard. So
right.
I kind of
right.
kind of slack back, you know what I'm saying? Mm. Everybody know me to respect me, and,
yeah.
you know, around the city.
Yeah.
So every time I go, it would be love. Like, yeah, man, blah, but they,
yeah.
they, like, the song so far, they're getting the DJs to spin the song.
Right.
The business wasn't it.
Right.
You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Right.
So I kind of fell back on it. You uh-huh. know what I'm saying? And uh-huh. then, I said, man, you know, I find it strange that every time I go, yeah, people want to show love,
uh-huh.
but they're not playing my song.
Right.
So I
right.
said, well, you know what? I'm going to try something.
Yeah.
I said, I brought my people. He came with my little camera.
Yeah.
And then I said, let's try this. This is going to be new.
Yeah. yeah.
And I start walking downtown like I normally do
yeah.
with my
yeah.
CD. But the only difference is, say, yeah, this your boy P. James from Real Talk TV.
Yeah.
I'm in Lafayette, Louisiana.
Yeah.
We downtown. Got all my people around. Yo, holler, you know, holler at everybody, let everybody know what's
yeah.
going on.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, man, what's going on? We out chilling Lafayette, Louisiana.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, hey, I might have something. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I start talking, walking down the strip, talking to random people.
Right.
You know what
right.
I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
I'm like, okay, they're reacting to it. Next thing you know, I bumped into Doc.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
There we go. We done built a platform for me doing that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I've seen her on the standby. I've looked at her in her eyes, but I didn't actually know this would have actually
right.
came, you know, came this far. So
I hear you.
As an artist trying to get, you know, trying to get my music out there,
right.
struggling artist trying mm-hmm. to get my music out there.
Mm-hmm.
I done came from being an artist to having somebody help me, you
yeah.
know what I'm saying,
right.
a promoter.
Right.
And then from having a promoter to actually taking my television show, which was done on the corner
right.
and in my house,
exactly.
to live television.
That's real.
You know what I'm saying?
Already.
And so whoever's saying that they can't do something, you
yeah.
know what I'm saying,
yeah.
they need to go ahead on and re-strategize on
yeah.
what they do.
That's right.
Because
right.
what I was doing wasn't working.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But when
right.
I went out there and I started doing it with these cameras and all that,
right.
mm-hmm. that started working.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
y'all don't hate. You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
That's
y'all participate.
Talk.
If y'all can't get it like y'all want, y'all figure out another idea.
Yeah.
yeah.
Find another way.
Y'all
for real.
Wait on
yeah.
the fit. What y'all trying to do?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Me?
Because
mm-hmm. y'all can hate all y'all want, but if y'all
2 minutes
and
the song's come on.
Then we're going to make it happen.
Okay. All right. GJ, give me your contact information.
I know how to contact me on Facebook. If y'all don't, I'm going to tell y'all again. P. James Murray on Facebook. And on Instagram, it's PJames_new_Erica.
All right. Rob, give your information.
You can reach me on Facebook, Bobby Roberson Sr., or you can reach me on Instagram at RobersonB3, or you can email me at HardHatEntertainment, just like it's spelled, at yahoo.com.
All right, and this is Dolly Pierre. You can catch me on Facebook under Dolly Pierre or Louisiana Music Promo. You can catch me on Instagram at Louisiana Music Promotion. Twitter, the same thing, Louisiana Music Promo. Even with Tumblr. And you can also find me, which is a good connection to catch do, and I would suggest other people start doing it, but be careful, don't go get put in Facebook jail behind you. Flippagram is awesome. I have over 55,000 views.
Man.
On Flippagram from some little videos that I've done for different artists.
Right.
I even made one of myself, but I got stuff on there.
Uh-huh.
And I have over 55,000 views, which is a good little revenue
right.
to put your views out, you know, to get people to watch your stuff.
Right.
And it's popping.
Working.
Yeah.
It's
that's
working.
What's up.
Y'all can call me at 337-789-2323. Call me for an interview. Let's sit down. Let's talk. You know, let's see what we can do. Let's see how we can help you get yourself known out there. If you don't try it, you won't know about it.
Yeah.
yeah, that's what
you're right,
man. And make sure y'all definitely go ahead on and stay tuned to the Underground Radio Show and download the KJCB app.
Right.
This month alone, I'm at 178,000 listeners. So let's go.
That's
what I'm saying. Let's keep
and
going.
We'll catch y'all tomorrow night.
That's right.
At KJCB.
Make sure you download the app and check us out live.
And y'all will hear B-Rob song. We will be doing who we.
I know that's right. B-Rob.
I'm gonna show you the video, but I don't want Facebook to go in on and get in trouble. So with that being said, man,
all right, we got our video. You ready?
Et toi, Bobby Boucher. Rob in here, you know what I'm talking about? Man, I wanna take my girl to the dance floor, you know what I'm talking about, and get it in. Swing out, rock out, and do what we do, you know what I'm saying? Let's go!
You wanna make her feel good.
I wanna make my baby feel good.
Take her out on
control.